मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर स्टडिंग साइंस 1 इन द चैप्टर 3 केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड इक्वेशन. इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द केमिकल रिएक्शन, इट्स केमिकल फिजिकल स्टेट्स बेस्ड ऑन द एक्टिविटीज, द केमिकल रिएक्शंस विद द एग्जांपल्स, द केमिकल इक्वेशन एंड रूल्स फॉर राइटिंग द केमिकल इक्वेशन. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडीज बैलेंसिंग अ केमिकल इक्वेशन. Before that, let's see what is a balanced chemical equation. In a chemical reaction, the number of atoms of the elements in the reactant is same as the number of atoms of those elements in the product. Such equation is called a balanced equation. You can see here this equation is balanced. That is, silver nitrate plus sodium chloride gives silver chloride plus sodium nitrate. How? I will show you. Consider one atom on both the sides of reactant and product, it is same or not. Take us silver in the reactant, it is one, product also it's one. Nitrogen in the reactant, it is one, product also it's one. Then oxygen in the reactant, it is three, product also it's three. Sodium in the reactant, it is one, product also it's one. Chlorine in the reactant, it is one, product also it's one. So you can say that this reaction is balanced. Now see the steps in balancing a chemical reaction. First is, write the chemical equation from the given word equation. This is the word equation in which sodium hydroxide plus sulfuric acid gives sodium sulfate plus water. This you have to write down the chemical formulas, that is NaOH plus H2SO4 gives Na2SO4 plus H2O. And now see the number of atoms in the reactant and product are same or not. Second step, check whether the equation is balanced or not by comparing the number of atoms in the various elements present on the two sides of the equation. Sodium in the reactant it is 1, product it is 2. Oxygen in the reactant it is 5, product also it's 5. Hydrogen in the reactant it is 3, product it is 2. Sulfur in the reactant, it is one, product also one. Sodium and hydrogen are uneven, so you have to balance this equation. Third, it is convenient to start balancing an equation from the compound which contain maximum number of atoms. Moreover, it is convenient to first consider that element in this compound which has unequal number of atoms on the two sides. In the reactant it is NaOH and in the product it is Na2SO4. So you have multiplied 2 in the reactant side to balance the equation, you can see here. But to balance sodium, now the number of oxygen and hydrogen is being increased in the reactant side. So you have to balance that. So first you have to balance the hydrogen as it requires a small factor. So apply 2 in the product H2O here. You have to apply 2. So now consider the atoms of each elements on the reactant and product are same or not. Sodium in the reactant it is 2, product also it's 2. Oxygen in the reactant it is 6, product also it is 6. Hydrogen in the reactant it is 4, product also it's 4. Sulfur in the reactant it is 1 and product also it's 1. Hence now you can say this equation is being balanced now. So you have to write down these steps if they have told to balance the equation along with the steps. So you have to write in this format. Now we will consider some examples. This is the equation which is being given. See, it is balanced or not. It is unbalanced. So write down the elements, number of atoms of reactant and number of atoms of the product. Hydrogen it is 4, in the reactant product it is 2. Sulfur it is 2 and 1 in the product. Oxygen it is 8 and 4. Thus we have to equalize the number of hydrogen atom, sulfur atom and oxygen atoms. We use 2 as the coefficient or factor in the product. You can see here, you are multiplying 2 on the product side to balance the equation. Now count the number of atoms are same or not. You will find that it is same. So finally, when you are writing the equation, you can write it with its physical states of the reactant and the product. Next example also, here the equation is being given. Consider the number of atoms on both the sides of reactant and product are same or not. This reaction is unbalanced. So write down the elements and number of reactant and the product. Sulfur, it is 2 in the reactant and in the product it is 1. Oxygen, 2 in the reactant and product it is 1. Hydrogen, 2 in the reactant and product it is 2. So the number of hydrogen atom on both the sides are equal, but to equalize the number of sulfur atom and oxygen atoms, you have to balance the number of sulfur atom first. So in the reactant side, you will take SO2 and H2S, but in the product side, it is sulfur. So here you have balance by multiplying it by 2. So to equalize the sulfur atom, we use 2 as the factor in the product, and now the equation becomes this. Here you can see you have put 2 in the product side. To equalize the number of oxygen atom in the unbalanced equation, so SO2 in the reactant side, H2O in the product side, you have to multiply 2 in the product to balance the oxygen. Now see, this is the oxygen molecule and you have put 2, so oxygen is being now balanced. But the number of hydrogen atom is unbalanced in the equation, so you will balance hydrogen atom now. So in the reactant side you will take H2S and in the product you will take H2O. So multiplying 2 in the reactant side, here you can see, so that the reaction becomes balanced for the hydrogen. Now see whether the number of elements on both the side of the equation, there are less number of sulfur atom in the product. Hydrogen is balanced, but now sulfur is uneven. So now equalize the sulfur atom in the balance equation becomes this, SO2 plus 2H2S. Now you have put here 3 in the sulfur side plus 2H2O. Now this equation is being balanced. So you can write down the physical states along with the reaction. Here are some other examples that you can solve. If they have given just the equation and tell directly to balance without writing these steps, these are the examples in which you have to write all these steps and solve it. So first see the question carefully and write down the answer accordingly. The reaction has been given and they have told to balance the equation. So here you can directly write down by seeing the atoms on both the sides. First consider Ag, it is 1 in the reactant side, product also is 1, so it is balanced. Hydrogen, here it is 2, but here it is 1 in the reactant, but product it is 2. So hydrogen is not balanced. So what you can do, you can put 2 in the reactant side and now see either balance or not. It's not balanced because here if you put 2, then number of chlorine atom gets increased. So here also you have to put 2. Now see the reaction is balanced or not. No, because Ag here it is 2, but here it's 1. So for that you will put 2 here, 2 here, and 2 here. Now see the equation is balanced or not. Now the equation is balanced, right? 2 atoms of silver, here also 2 atoms. 2 atoms of hydrogen, here also 2 atoms of hydrogen. 2 atoms of chlorine, here again, here also 2 atoms of chlorine. So the reaction is now balanced. Now consider the next example. The equation is given, NaOH plus H2SO4 gives Na2SO4 plus H2O. Consider first the sodium atoms. Here it is 1, but here it is 2. So you will put 2 here. Now the oxygen and hydrogen atom has been increased in the reactant side and the product side it is less. So you will put 2 here on this side. Now count the number of atoms are same or not. You will find that the number of atoms are same. Hence, the equation's answer is been given here. And I have said this symbol denotes the precipitation, whereas this symbol denotes the gas which has been released from the reaction. So now these are the examples that you have to balance the chemical reaction. Now I think you can solve many other examples based on the steps which I have taught you.